Hi, welcome to another new video from the City Traveler. Today I'm taking you on another fun city trip, and this time, Athens. Want more videos about city trips or traveling? Then don't forget to subscribe and like. Today I take you through the sites you can visit in Athens. My advice is to stay two or more days in Athens if you want to see everything. Let's start at the Plaka and the shopping streets. When in Athens, be sure not to skip Plaka. This district is full of atmospheric stores and nice taverns. It is incredibly busy though, as this is the most popular part of the Athens among tourists. Stroll around for an afternoon, shop for souvenirs, and immerse yourself in the coziness. Acropolis. If you spend longer in Athens, visiting the Pantheon and the Acropolis is a sight not to be missed. Built in 447 before Christ, the Pantheon was a temple for Athena, the city's goddess. To think that this temple has been standing for 2,500 years is truly unreal. The Acropolis Museum. The Acropolis Museum is one of the best attractions you can visit in Athens. If you want to better understand the context and history of the Acropolis before you visit it, you should definitely visit the Acropolis Museum first. In this museum, you will find nearly 4,000 ancient artifacts and objects. The museum is very interesting and well-designed, and from the panoramic terrace on the third floor, you will have a great view of the Acropolis. The Ancient Agora. Another great site in Athens is the Ancient Agora. The Agora was the main square of ancient Athens. It was considered the cultural, political, commercial, and social center of the city. Today, it lies largely in ruins, but it's still worth a visit, especially for the view. Temple of Hephaestus. Built in the time of Pericles in 449 BC, this temple is one of the best-preserved Doric temples in Greece. The National Archaeological Museum of Athens. If you enjoyed the Acropolis Museum, then you really should visit the National Archaeological Museum of Athens. The museum is known worldwide for its collection of beautiful antiquities. This impressive building offers more than 8,000 square meters of exhibition space where you will find fantastic collections from the Neolithic to the end of the Roman period. The National Park and the Zapeion Park. If you want to enjoy a little greenery during your stay in Athens, you should definitely take a walk in the National Park and the Zapeion Park. The two are actually one and the same large park, marking it the largest public park in Athens. This is the best place to relax and take a break away from the crowds. The park is located between Panteoneic Stadium and Syntagma Square. Syntagma Square. Admittedly, it is very touristy and crowded, but at the same time, it is fun to witness this tradition in real life. If you are near Syntagma Square, be sure to check if the changing of the guard happens to be happening just now. The metro station, which is located under Syntagma Square, is also worth a visit. In Athens, excavations are not allowed to be moved, so they are located in the craziest places, including the metro station. Ermo Street. If you want to go shopping in Athens, it is definitely on Ermo Street. This pedestrian street leads to Syntagma Square to the Monastiriki district. Being the main shopping street of Athens, you will find the majority of major international brands like H&M, Zara, Marks & Spencer, and many bars and restaurants. Monastery District. We continue to the Monastery District in the district Monastiriki. This is located in the center of Athens, next to the Plaka district. Monastiriki Square, with its Byzantine church, is the heart of this lively and cosmopolitan district. You will enjoy walking the narrow streets with many small stores of all kinds. Plaka District. Another place to visit in Athens is the Plaka District. Athens' oldest district is often called the District of the Gods because it is located at the foot of the Acropolis. Although it is a very busy and touristy area, Plaka has maintained its picturesque charm with its narrow streets and beautiful houses. During your visit, you can enjoy Byzantine buildings as well as classical houses. With its many stores, it is also a good place to buy local products or souvenirs. Monte Lycabettus. If you want to enjoy a breathtaking view of the Acropolis, you must climb Mount Lycabettus. Mount Lycabettus, 278 meters high, is also called the Hill of the Wolves, and is definitely the best place to enjoy a 360 degrees panorama of Athens. Arriving at the top, you may see the charming Orthodox Chapel, St. George. You can reach the top of Lycabettus on foot. A 20-minute walk uphill will take you to the top. By cable car, the Lycabettus cable car takes only 3 minutes to reach the top. The return ticket costs 7 euros and the departure point is at the intersection of Aristopou and Ploutarchou streets. By car. The Philopappos Hill. If you think you have seen everything in Athens and if you have already visited the main neighborhoods, you should go to Philopappos Hill, also known as the Moses Hill. It is one of the best vantage points to see Athens and the Acropolis. On this 147-meter-high hill, you can reach the top in about 10 minutes, thanks to it's one of the pedestrian paths. From the top, you have a panoramic view of the entire city, the port of Piraeus, and the Attic Peninsula. If you are lucky enough to have very clear weather, you can even see some of the nearest islands. The Roman Agora. The Roman Agora is another attraction in Athens. Don't confuse it with the ancient agora I mentioned earlier. The agora of Roman Forum is located in the Plaka district. It was built between 19 and 11 BC. There was a large central market, several stores, and public latrines. The most notable elements of the agora are the Gate of Athena Archegetis with its four well-preserved columns, the recently renovated Fethiye Dami Mosque, where temporary exhibitions are held, the Tower of the Winds, a marble tower built by Andronicus of Cyrus for use as a compass, sundial and weather clock. Other great tips when in Athens are bike tour of Athens. Especially if you have little time to spend in Athens, a guided bike tour is highly recommended. This will take you past all the highlights and main attractions in few hours. This way can be sure that you don't miss anything in Athens, even if you are only there for a short time. By boat from Athens to an island. Of course, it is also possible to take a boat towards one of the islands off the mainland coast. The Saronic Islands are among the islands closest to Athens. The best Saronic Islands to see. Aegina, where you can visit the Temple of Aphaia and the remains of Palaeochora, an ancient Byzantine village. Agistri and its many small bays. Poros, for its beautiful colorful houses. Hydra, an island where cars are forbidden. It is the perfect destination if you want to go hiking and enjoy the beautiful beaches. Spetses, covered with pine trees and a great place for biking. If you only have a day to discover the Saronic Islands, you can book a cruise. Everything is included. From Athens, a bus takes you to the port of Piraeus, and from there you go to the islands. Athens is a city with many attractions and opportunities. Definitely a city trip on your bucket list. I hope you got something out of my tips again, and don't forget to like and subscribe. See you on the next trip.